You're such an asshole.
Give me all of your money. Good night, everyone. Good night. Good night. Thank you. Thank you. And good night. Yes. Wait, come on. You don't trust yourself to make these. You got to trust me on this one, right? Who are you going to trust me? You going to trust me? Why are you going to trust you? You got to trust me on this. I'm me. You're you. Got to trust me. All right. More seriously. I love getting requests like this because there are these men out there who played their cards right. Showing you can still be successful. And gee, where have all the good men gone? Cappy, there ain't no women around. Oh my God, I got billions of dollars. What do I do? Hello, Aaron, longtime follower, returning client. Just keep my name and job title anonymous. I'm 28, married, live in PA. Oh, I got what she got to him. She got to him. Dang it. And you live in a place, you make over $400,000 a year in debt free. You work as a STEM guy in a field. Workload is light, about 10 hours a week, although I expect that to change in the future. I worked hard and made huge sacrifices. You did what now? Wait, what did you do? You worked. Huh. I wonder if the people under 30 know what that is. And you did it hard? And then you made sacrifices? Huge sacrifices to get this far, especially considering it came from a difficult and broken family. At this point, I do not know what to do next, and I'm fairly bored in my situation. My job situation is pretty solid. I generally enjoy my work. I'm also pursuing an online part-time master's in a STEM field on the side, which helps to supplement me with more work whenever I get bored at my job. It will be a nice round out on my resume. I thought about switching to a finance degree or an MBA. What? No. Sorry, sir, your dick is too big. You need a really small micro dick, and your brain is also too big. You need a small dick, small brain, then you can major in finance. An MBA, you would hate the MBA. You would hate it. Now that the sheen is off, that it's not like some kind of science behind it. It's just a bunch of common sense platitudes and bullshit taught up by washed up people who couldn't hack it in the real world. You don't need an MBA. But every time I research those options, it always seems like those degrees are generally worthless, just like the people who take them. Eventually, I will want to move up and take another job with greater seniority, but I am in no hurry to do so right now. Yeah, go get your master's in the STEM field. You don't need an MBA or finance. What would you do in my situation? I'm so used to running at 500 miles per hour that it feels so incredibly strange to me to not have to do that anymore. I had to work full time to put myself through school. Combine that with my undergrad STEM degree, I ended up having to work 80 to 100 hour work weeks. Oh, that sounds awfully familiar. In some ways, I am sympathetic to the millennials and Zoomers because they are lied to. But then it's like, okay, now that you know you've been lied to, get off your ass and kick ass, because I did the same thing. So their complaints fall on my ears deftly when it's like, yeah, I had to work 80 to 100 hours a week, as did you. I've never really had the opportunity to explore hobbies and interests before. From what I understand from watching your videos, you had a very similar background. I think travel is a good place to start. I agree. But I am interested in your opinion. Since I grew up pretty poor and my family could not afford to travel, I've been thinking about doing a ton of travel across the U.S. My job requires me to be in the office 3 days a week. My wife works remotely. Awesome. So we could travel on my remote days and work elsewhere across the U.S. I'm planning on going to Florida, Texas, Colorado, Nevada, and MA. Is that Massachusetts or is that Maine? I also thought about looking to buy a home, but I cannot justify it to myself with the insanely high interest rates and prices I'm seeing right now. Plus, if you were to take Reconnaissance Man, or if you read, I'm sorry, read the book Reconnaissance Man, you'd find out that if you don't know where you want to live, there's no reason for you to buy a house. And the reason I agree with you on travel being the first thing you should do is the very first thing someone should do after gaining skills and kind of getting established a little bit is travel, not for fun, but to find out where you belong. I'm trying to remember. That's in the menu. I go into lengthy detail about why it's critically important to travel And not Bipsy Travel. OMG, Eduardo, I love your Latino penis. Don't tell my husband. I'm just finding myself in Spain. La 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 la. Not that kind of find yourself. If Eduardo's dick ends up in your mouth, you're doing it wrong. You should be looking for a place to live, like where you belong. And that is in the book, The Menu, which I also have linked below. So I'm just going to tell you right now that it's very, 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 unless you give me some other information, that is very likely the best use of your time. And it is an investment. It's a fun investment. This is what happens when we all put our work up front. Then you get to do the fun stuff later on. And for quite some time, too. Florida, Texas, Colorado, maybe Nevada, I agree. Try Tennessee as well. Montana, unless you know, but you can read reconnaissance, man. You'll figure it out. And prices that I am seeing right now, maybe they always be this high. I do not know. You don't control it, so don't worry about it. Your first job is to find out where you belong. And there are ways for you to buy a house that is affordable, like buying land first and paying it down, building a small house that only you and your wife need, getting a RV and putting it on the land, making sure the land you buy, you can have an RV, building your own home. But I'd rather wait a little bit to see where the market is going to go. Don't worry about it. You don't control it. Stop worrying about it. Knock it off. Don't worry about it. And with the money you make, and it's just the two of you, you don't need that big of a place. Don't worry about it. And David, what would you do in my situation? Thanks for the advice and content you put out. Regards to that. So then I ask, how much effort have you put into finding where you'd like to retire? Like in terms of town and state, very little. Also, how much international travel have you done? None. Very interested in visiting Singapore, Australia, South Korea. I'd skip Australia. No offense to our Aussies in the audience. We've never been outside the United States. Okay, there you go. That's what I'd be doing. I'd be traveling a lot. And with the primary goal of figuring out where you want to live, because this is going to give you a project to chew on. It's also going to give you, this is not like it takes energy, but this isn't a hard chore like working 80 to 100 hours a week. This is, okay, sweetheart, we're going to go check out Denver. Oh my gosh, there's a lot of potheads here. We're going to go check out Vegas. Like, oh, maybe we should leave the strip. I should do like the major cities in the United States. Baltimore. Wow, what a shithole. I thought this was Detroit. It's going to be an enjoyable hobby for you to chew on. Matter of fact, if it started to run into your studies for the online or for your your master's degree, I'd almost put the master's degree secondary to this. And what you'll do is you'll find out after traveling. It's going to take at least a year if you do it right. You're going to have to check out here. A lot of 4-day weekends I see. Or 5-day weekends with your schedule. A lot of traveling I see. Maybe like, oh, I don't want to book a flight again. Yeah, too bad. Go book a flight and drive. This is an investment. And slowly you start to find out where you want to live. And one of these days, I think you're going to come across a town where you and your wife are like, wow. This is nice. And I narrow it as down as much as I can in reconnaissance, man, so you're not wasting too much time. You say, boy, I really want to be here. This is where I really want to be. And then the next stage would be finding your home. And then whether you find a home that already exists or you build your home that doesn't exist, you're going to have at least 2 years of projects for you to work on to tailor the home, decorate the home, make the home your actual home. And then that will carry you through to the next point, at which point in time I'd start looking more at like hobbies. Like, did you ever want to do motorcycle riding? Like the fun hobbies. You got your base of operations. You figure out where you want to live. By the way, you don't have to wait until you have a home and it's all set and tailored. All right, now I go have fun. If you want to pick up fishing, dude, go pick up some fishing. All right. If you want to go ride a motorcycle, pick it up. You're used to doing 80 to 100 hours. Like, the great thing about people like you and me is an Atham. It's, dude, you're working, what, 10 hours a week? You got 70 in the tank, man. You could learn a motorcycle ride, power paraglide. and get some travel in. So whatever your bucket list is, which if you don't know what it is, you got to sit down and figure it out. You know, figure out what your wife wants to do too. And like, hey, do you want to try this with me? That might be fun. Yeah, now it's just as you had to sit down and plan your career, you have to sit down and plan the fun and what you want to do. And that takes time to figure out and a lot of trial and error. Just sampling things. Not really error. You'll try and like, ah, I don't like that. I don't like pickleball. Okay, pickleball ain't for you, but you tried it. So I'm like, oh, I failed. I'll also be perfectly honest. If you got your wife involved, both of you should be into physical health and fitness because the number one vice, number one thing would be having fun sex. Sorry, just what it is. that'll take some time, like going to the gym if you haven't been going to the gym already. But yeah, strategic planning wise, travel, find out where you want to live. And then you build a house, buy a house, and then you can hit me up in another 5 years or so. What do I do now? Which then gets to the other point I was going to make. I'm older than you. I didn't have as much success as you did at 28. I got my success later on. But it's a constant, you're going to fight novelty. And I've talked about this before. Everything has a shelf life. You'll be excited about this. And you'll be like, I'm not as excited about motorcycle riding as I used to be in times past. hiking has stuck with me a long time. That's done me well. But it is a challenge where you wake up, you're like, what do I want to do? And I'm at the point where it's like, I want to sit on my ass and watch Gintama. I bought the series. So I just want to kind of binge on that and figure, I mean, there's going to be times where you got to rest. But it's a chore and it's a obligation to yourself that you have to do. where you find out, okay, what do I like next? And I'm coming up on one of those stages where, okay, everything's kind of squared away. Did the house get hit by lightning again? It didn't. Oh my God. I might have a whole fucking year where I'm left alone. I'm coming up on one of those. Okay. I got to figure out something to do. And it's probably going to be power paragliding. I'm going to be doing that. And I do want to get into a martial arts that is not jujitsu. I, no offense to people who did jujitsu and you like it. I tried it. I did more than tried. I did it a fair amount. I hated it. Hated every second of it. Just hated it. Want to get into something where I'm throwing a punch and I'm not, some guy's foot is not in my face. but you need to be on that. Now, if you had kids, then if you and your wife had kids, that would consume all your time. And you'd have, and I would wait until you got your dream home where you want to live. Not the big ass dream home, the practical dream home, your forever home. If you want to have kids, that would take up a lot. And then 20 years from now, you finally come up for breath. What do I do? Who am I? But if you don't want to have kids, yeah, then it is a chore, a lifetime chore to figure out what you're going to do next. And you have to, because if you don't, you will have regret like you wasted your life. So that's pretty much it. let me give you a couple things that you could consider in addition to, if you're religious, start getting into religion. If you sincerely believe it, if you don't, try, fraternal organizations or professional organizations, something like that. You need to get the hell, cause I'll tell you this, if you and your wife are living together all the time, working at home, you're going to need to get away from each other. what else? I'd start binging on some philosophy podcasts, particularly Schopenhauer and the Stoics. And then else, I don't want to give the whole book away. I'm just trying to give you things to move or two down the road or something to do on the side. I get into a good vice. Like if you want to try whiskeys, now's the time to start trying your whiskeys. You like beer, go try the beers. I have this friend, the couple friend. They're not weird, but their choice is weird. They wanted to go to all the presidential libraries. That was their thing. And I don't think they've hit them all. They've hit a lot of them. But they're like, oh, my God, we went to the Lyndon B. Johnson. I'm like, I can't believe you're so excited about this. But, you know, that's what they like to do. I don't know. Maybe you and your wife, you like wiener dogs, go to wiener dog festivals. I, curiously enough, actually enjoy antique stores. Not because of the crap that's in there, but because every once in a while you find something that's cool. Or you get a pretty good deal on silver if they don't do their pricing right. So whatever it is that you want to do, I'd recommend that. But yeah, you start to look at religion, philosophy, community organizations, things like that. But I'd almost wait until you're in your established forever home before you do that. And so then to help with that, link below is the menu, Life Without the Opposite Sex. Even though you have a wife, I would still read through it because it's things to do in life. In addition to, in your case, having a wife. And then Reconnaissance Man, please read that. That's just going to save you a shit ton of money and time. So you're not wasting your time going to New Mexico. No offense to New Mexico. It's just, it isn't that great. JJ Sefton, what's going on, man? You're all over the place. You need to get a good 30-year scotch. I agree with him. I think Power Paraglide, step two, get a religion. No, I just want to do power paragliding. I saw that when I was a kid. There must have been like a place for him to take off back in Milwaukee. And I saw that all the time. I was like, magic. Still want to do it. Yeah, I think he should get into scotches or maybe cigars or something a little. Golf. I like golf. Get into golf. All right. JJ Sefton, $2. Client should learn to drive a motorcycle. Just saying. Yeah, he should. I'm all for motorcycles. Murph Wilds, $2. Oh, is this a girl or it looks like a girl. Oh, she's been here before. Cappy, why don't you produce a documentary? Because it takes, what? That sounds like work, man. Why would, what would I document? I got books. Somebody take my books and turn it into a documentary. I don't want to make a doc. That sounds laborious. That sounds like I got to edit. Sounds like I got to worry about my, that sounds like production. That sounds expensive. No, I want to ride my motorcycle and hike and do my thing. And I do not want to produce any documentaries. All right, there you go. We'll see you guys later. Toodles.